Look what I've got for you. You'll love this.
A cross, nicely carved. Someone in the village might recognize it.
Yeah.
I hope I can be of help to you, Knight.
Do you know anything about local brawlers?
Why do you ask?
I like a good punch-up myself, so I'm keen on meeting like-minded fellows.
Then you're in luck, because I'm in charge of all the fights here. You want to join in right now, or have you any questions?
What are the rules?
Nothing complicated. Don't you worry. First thing, no weapons. Try that once, and you're finished. Second, you can't walk away. Jump the fence, and that's the end. You lose.
How does it work?
Easy. You come to the others and challenge them. Wager against each other, and if you win, you get your stake back, plus the same again from the fellow you beat.
I like the sound of that.
Don't get carried away, though. If you beat someone and then challenge him again, He won't be too keen on betting. Understand?
I want to fight.
Well, if you're as good as you are keen, it'll surely be interesting. But before the two of us start brawling, you have to beat the others.
Who are they? And where can I find them?
Lads from Ujits. Mash, Maple, and Ma. Joseph.
I'm looking for the owner of this cross. Do you happen to know whose it is?
No, I don't. But why not ask the priest? He blesses all the crosses in the village.
Thanks. I'll ask him.
God be with you.
Hey.
Wait, is someone there?
Lost something hereabouts.
God be with you. Take care now.
Vodenka studena, vodenka studena. Dibi.
Good day to you.
Farewell.
My respects to you.
The village folk said you consecrate the crosses they keep at home.
Indeed I do. Why do you ask, Hal?
I was just wondering if you could remember who owns this one.
I could, but I might not want to tell you.
Why?
People said they saw you talking with a vicar. They're afraid that Sir Hanu sent you here to help him.
That's not how it is.
And how is it?
Sir Hanush sent me to find out what he wants, and to get him out of here if possible.
Well, then we share the same interest, but I'd still prefer it to end with nobody burned at the stake.
Sir Hanush was quite clear. I'm to see to it that the vicar leaves, and when he finds what he's looking for, he'll go away, won't he?
Eventually. But you can't even imagine the horror he can unleash. Where did you find the cross?
Let's do a deal. I'll tell you where I found it, and you tell me whose it is.
Very well. Tell me.
I found it in the woods. It looked like people met there. There were other things, candles, a cloth, and so on.
Damn it! That really does seem like...
That the vicar is right to be looking here. It surprised me, too. So whose is it?
The cross is definitely the Bowers, I remember that. But that just can't be. I can't believe it. If they really are heretics, though...
What do you want to do?
I don't know. But I'll do anything in my power to prevent a heretic witch hunt taking hold here.
I see. It wouldn't make Sir Hanush too happy either.
My thoughts exactly. But the question still remains what to do about it. The vicar won't give up till he's found what he wants. You know what, boy? Before we do anything else, we ought to make sure whether there really are heretics here.
What do you propose?
That's simple. Listen to how they say their prayers.
What good will that do us?
Prayers are sacred to all Christians, heretic or devotee. But if they are heretics, they're bound to pray differently.
And how will I know there's something wrong with their prayers?
Don't you know how true Christians pray?
I suppose so. But how can I listen to their private prayers? I don't suppose they'll be praying that way in the church.
Certainly not. In the church, they'd pray the usual way. But at home, it's a different matter entirely. I know they meet at the farm in the evening with all the domestics. They'll surely be praying then.
All right. But how can I listen in?
I don't know. Crouch beneath the window? Climb up in the loft? That way you'll be sure to hear everything said in the main room.
Right, I'll get on with it.
Farewell.
Thank you.
I am at your service, Sir Knight.
The fisherman sent me to you. Said you'd be up for a brawl.
Is that so? Well, we haven't had any new blood here for a while. But if you want an easier scrap, you should go to Maple or Joseph. I don't like to blow my own trumpet, but I'm damn good. Either way, you'll wager a few groschen, right? May the Lord watch over you.
God!
Yeah. Yeah.
Thief! Stop him, someone! Catch him! Thief! Thief! Stop him, someone!
Come on!
You showed him. And did you get the loot back?
I did. I have it here.
Thank you, that thieving magpie. You can't trust anyone these days. And just so you know, I'm no pinch purse. Here's a small reward.
Thanks.
We went to the stables, and those cutthroats were waiting for us there and set about trying to kill us all too.
Yeah.
God save you. What can I do for you?
The fisherman told me you'd be up for a brawl. Is it true?
Aye, if you've a mind to. Take care now.
Stop!
Jesus!
God be with you.
Are you one of the local pugilists? The fisherman told me you weren't averse to a bit of friendly violence.
I'm glad you showed up. It's been as dull as hell here. Joseph doesn't talk much and the fisherman is, well, slippery as a fish. Take care now.
Whoa.
Take that.
Look what I've got for you. You'll love this. That's a good boy. That's my boy.
I hope I can be of help to you, Knight.
Let's fight.
All right. Good. You put on a pretty good show. Let's spice it up with a few groschen, eh?
May the Lord...
Yeah.
Good health to you.
Good luck to you.
I hope I can be of some humble service to you.
Have you got a bed for the night?
But you've already got a place to sleep.
No, thank you. Is there anything suspicious going on in these parts?
Nothing out of the ordinary, praise God.
I hope I can be of some humble service to you. Good luck to you.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah.
Ah, I could try listening from here.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Bless us, O Lord, and these thy gifts which we are bound to receive from thy bounty. Through Christ our Lord. Amen.
Amen. Amen.
They took old Wenzel to the presbytery today. His farm is nearby. It's only a matter of time before...
Before they come for me. I know.
And what are we going to do about it? That vicar is baying for blood, the beast. He will devour you alive.
I do not intend to do anything about it. I shall not waver from my faith, nor turn my back on it.
My dear, what on earth are you saying?
If they come for me, I will go quietly. And I will not lie.
Are you serious? Don't you know what they'll do to you?
I can well imagine. But I am resolved.
The Lord have mercy.
Do not fear. I surrender to God's will. And I do not condemn you if you decide to leave.
I'll stay by your side. Although I'd rather that you decided otherwise.
I know. And you have no fear, my brothers in Christ. Stay true to God's plan, as I shall. Go and spread the true faith amongst all good folk.
I'm sorry. I wish there was another way.
You should eat your supper and depart right away. Who knows? You may come for us at dawn.